Hey guys, Brian here from High Impact Flicks. I'm just sitting here waiting in a government line. That's right, every time you're at a stoplight or a stop sign, you're waiting in a government line. You know, there was an ancient philosopher from the 3rd century BC named Mencius who once wrote that to act without clear understanding, to form habits without investigation, to travel a path all one's life without knowing where it really leads, such is the behavior of a multitude. And wow, check this out. I'm sitting in yet another government line. Centuries later, Sam Adams would write, "It's not the majority who will prevail, but the irate and tireless minority who are keen on setting brush fires of freedom in the minds of men." And that's really part of what this channel is all about, to set those brush fires of freedom in the minds of people who are acting without clear understanding, who are forming habits without investigating things for themselves, and who are traveling this path all their life just subject to mainstream media and believing what their psychopathic political puppet politicians have to say. So that's kind of what this channel is all about. We'll add some funny stuff, some practical stuff, maybe some, you know, health and fitness, man on the street interviews. I'd like to, interview some police, maybe some police interaction, kind of get their take on what they think the Constitution means and if they enforce it, and if they would initiate force or coercion on somebody who hasn't violated anyone's rights. And really, that's what happens anytime they pull somebody over and let's say they have just a little bit of cannabis on board. You know, they take these people to jail. They ruin their lives. It costs them so much money just to get out of jail just because they possessed a plant. But today I want to talk about something that happened to me about a month and a half ago. I was driving through western Oklahoma and didn't know exactly where I was going, so I was paying more attention to my GPS than I was the road, and I slowly rolled through a stop sign. Well, it wasn't 5 seconds and the blue lights were upon me, and so that's what I want to talk about. So the name of this segment is tentatively Death by Traffic Ticket. Stay tuned. So I safely, slowly rolled through a stop sign in western Oklahoma, Cimarron County to be precise. I didn't hurt anybody, I didn't jeopardize anybody's safety, I didn't threaten anybody. I simply rolled through a stop sign. Mere moments later, a cop pulled me over and issued me a traffic ticket to the tune of $211.50. Now, I don't know when the last time was that you were in a traffic court, but last time I was there were over 100 people waiting in the courtroom, and each person was fined no less than $100 to $150. One guy was fined $1,350 because he possessed 2 grams of cannabis. The judge in that court emptied out the room in about an hour and a half. So in that one and a half hour session, that county made over $10,000 just in traffic stops alone. That was just in one courtroom presided over by one judge in one and a half hour period of time. There are many courtrooms in that building, and many courthouses in the entire state. So rather than calling them law enforcement, these people who are supposed to be serving and protecting are doing nothing more than harassing and collecting. The revenue generators, road pirates. Maybe I and others can afford a $211 traffic ticket, but what about that single mom who's trying to provide for her family, trying to put food on the table? This could potentially be devastating. But let's analyze this situation and call things what they really are. I safely rolled through an imaginary, arbitrary line in my own personal vehicle without stopping before I broke the plane of that one. At this point, the law, or edict of the politicians, is enacted and the enforcers take over. Once I broke that plane, I was followed by a special car with special sparkly lights, driven by a man wearing a special costume on which was pinned a special shiny badge. Now this officer is just a human being like you and me, but somehow this guy believes he has the authority over other people to randomly stop others for breaking a quote law, because other people who think they're special, called politicians, believe they also have special powers to scribble arbitrary words on fancy pieces of paper, and through some magical religious ritual called legislative action, can force another class of people to obey their edicts under the threat of force. Transgressing this edict or command, or what they call a law, gives them what they perceive as a right to detain you, harass you, find you, arrest you, cage you, or harm you. By the way, under this delusional process, whether people see it or not, whether a gun is drawn or not, there is the constant implied threat of force. Don't believe me? If you resist, if you drive away from a routine traffic violation after having been pulled over, or if you try to ignore them when they pull up behind you flashing their lights, they'll call for backup, and with the full power of the state, they will make sure that you're stopped, extracted from your car at gunpoint, thrown to the ground, handcuffed, and transported to a cage. This is going to cost you time, money, your reputation, and if you continue to resist, it may cost your very life. This is how serious this delusion is. Now keep in mind, neither you nor I have any inherent power or right to do this to anyone else. But they don't mind doing this to you. And it's somehow okay with people because it's the entity called government who foists these immoral acts upon the masses. Statism, or authoritarianism, is the cultic belief that it's okay for a select class of people to initiate force on others who haven't harmed or threatened anyone. And for people to consent to and condone such immoral acts is to be a part of a system that is against humanity itself. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching my first ever vlog post. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and share it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and other social media. Now I'm gonna try to make this channel just a little bit more interactive than the other channel. So if you have any ideas on what you'd like to see covered, just leave your comments in the comment section below this video, or you can contact me at contact@highimpactflix.com. That's my email. Or you can get in touch with me at facebook.com/highimpactflix, or just tweet me at highimpactflix. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, just hit that big red subscribe button down there. It really, really helps out a lot. Until next time, keep this in mind. It's easier to deceive the masses than to convince them that they've been deceived. You guys have a great day.